One of the prerequisites when it comes to being a great comic book villain is that you need to inspire fear in some form. Be it from brutish strength, the complete absence of morals, or simply working here at What Culture because we are the most evil people of them all.
You will take this list and you will love them!
Anyway, as you'd expect, it's almost a contest between these bad lads and lasses as to which are the most frightening, and it's gone so far into the realms of terror that the villains on this list have transcended the page and have caused us to lose sleep. With this in mind, I'm Jules for What Culture Comics, and these are 10 terrifying supervillains that gave you nightmares. Number 10, Victor Zsasz. If villains were colours, Victor Zsasz would be decidedly beige. In terms of the surreal world of Batman, he's a surprisingly conventional villain, armed only with a skill and a need for murder. The fact that, homicidal tendencies aside, that Zsasz is just a normal guy is just what makes him so scary, as out of all of the rogues gallery, he's the one that could easily exist in real life and live in Gateshead. His incessant need to tally his victims is yet more unnerving, as the only point which Zsasz will stop killing is when his body physically cannot hold any more marks. And as this is the same guy who plans to scar the inside of his eyelids after killing the Batman, it's likely that this murder limit is a very long way indeed. Number 9. Anton Arcane. Anton is scary for many of the same reasons that Zsasz is, being a crazy, unethical doctor with a big hard-on for the Nazi Party and for Satan. He mixes his occult deviances with his ingenious mind to perverted levels, and when you've got a man who's willingly put his own brain into one of his unmen, who are creatures who look like nightmare fuel for a living, you know that there's something off with this one. This transfer also added unnatural strength and a habit of being new to his already nightmarish form, making him more closely resemble a Silent Hill monster than a villain from the same company who brought us Calendar Man. Oh, Calendar Man, you look so sweet in comparison. And your name's Julian. Number 8, the Corinthian. Serial killers make up a decent chunk of the most frightening supervillains, and the Corinthian is no exception to this. Except instead of a regular human murderer, he is a nightmare created to reflect the evil within humanity, which is so much worse. A rough summary of the most frightening part of the Corinthian can actually be summarized in two awful words. Eye mouths. Mouths that are eyes. Mouths where the eyes should be. Eye mouths. Do I need to say anything more than eye mouths? Actually, that's not even the worst part of it, as the Corinthian eats you from the inside out, which sounds f***ing awful. But still, eye mouths. Number 7. Professor Pig. The weird thing about Professor Pig is that, by all accounts, he shouldn't be as frightening as he actually is. A chubby man who likes wearing pig masks on paper sounds almost funny. And yet every time that Pig stars in an issue, it is, without a doubt, terrifying, in no small part due to his penchant for performing lobotomies with drills. He's essentially Leatherface or Piggy from Manhunt, and neither are people you want over for dinner as you'd be on the goddamn menu. No, I like my skin where it is, thank you kindly. He's classic horror movie through and through, with evil experiments to make people perfect by deforming them, and has a bonk on for monologues. It might sound stock, but trust me, this hog will make you squeal. Number 6. Dr. Death. There are some powers that are incapable of not being horrific. Dr. Death is a prime example of this, as his power is a serum that generates uncontrolled bone growth in those who take it, just like me when your mum's around. There's my one per list. Worse still is that Dr. Death's appearance in the New 52 comes up at the beginning of Bruce Wayne's career as Batman, meaning that not only is the Dark Knight left to fight a horde of grotesquely misshapen humans with super strength, he's also doing it with comparatively little idea of how to combat them. Looking somewhere between a shark and a fungus, a fungark if you will, the only positive thing to say about Dr. Death's appearance is that it could probably make a dentist some serious money. And the fact that he did this to himself by choice is clear indication that while he looks like a mushroom, he ain't a fun guy. Puns, I've got them. Number 5. Superman from Red Sun. There is one particular trait shared amongst all the villainous versions of Superman. They are downright petrifying. The Superman from Red Sun is no exception to this, as over the course of the comic he evolves to become an iron-fisted dictator who aggressively controls the human race. And when you consider what the boy in red and blue can do, it's f***ing Skin Shiver City. All those powers. And the really unnerving thing is that he believes that what he's doing is right. It's just that his perception of this has been warped to the point where enslaving the human race is just a-okay. It serves to remind us that if Superman had landed anywhere else in the world, we might not be experiencing the same liberties as we do today. Liberties such as freedom of expression, music, and life, I guess. Bloody hell. Number 4. Scarecrow. Possibly the poster boy for fear-creating villains, Scarecrow's whole gimmick is centered around fear. He's also my favorite villain of all time. Hands down, this straw-stuffed spooker is so entertaining to see in action and is so f***ing devious that it's enticing in every sense of the word. One such aspect I love to be frightened by is the thought that his early fear serums were developed during his tenure as a psychologist on the mental patients at Arkham Asylum, meaning that totally helpless people were subjected to horrific mental torture with no chance of escape. There's zero empathy from Crane, and that's what makes him even more terrifying. Number 3. Venom. Superhero strength, flexible tendrils, and the ability to unhinge its jaw. No, I'm not talking about your dad, that's my one palist in a different form. But I'm talking about Venom, easily one of the most frightening Marvel villains. The fact that Venom appears so nightmarish is made all the worse by knowing that a human resides within its writhing tentacles, especially as it's often unclear whether the host is controlling the alien or vice versa. Now, this sentence will seem weird until I explain it. Venom has also possessed a car before. Which is terrifying, I know it sounds stupid, because now you have to deal with the thought that not only could any person around you be possessed by Venom, by an unstable alien murderer, but also any object too. How fun. Number 2. Purple Man. There are precisely two things not terrifying about Zebediah Kilgrave. The first one being his name, and the second one being that, as the name suggests, he is entirely bright purple. In spite of this, though, Kilgrave is undeniably one of the most unnerving supervillains to date on account of his mind control powers, which give him the ability to make anyone do anything. These powers are often used solely to scar others, both mentally and physically, and mainly just for Kilgrave's entertainment. Kilgrave only really took on this terrifying persona after his appearance in the 2001-2004 comic series Alias, where we learned that he kept Jessica Jones prisoner through his powers for several months, a time in which he filled with torturing her psychologically and physically. It's easy for a villain to be frightening physically, but Kilgrave proves that doing despicable things to powerless people is far, far worse. And number 1, Mr. Bloom. While the Joker certainly has his nightmarish qualities, he's such a well-known villain that it almost works against him at this point in comics. Nothing the Joker does is nearly as terrifying as this lovely-looking monster man, Mr. Bloom. Introduced in the New 52, we've got no sad origin or backstory for this beast, but that makes it all the more uncomfortable to see in action. We don't know much about it, and what we don't know sure as hell keeps us up at night. He developed out of the distrust a post-Year One Gotham has for its fellow occupants, the divides between all of them, and while Batman can beat him up, righting those wrongs is a whole different story. Batman can beat Mr. Bloom, but he cannot defeat what made him, and the concept of a villain who cannot truly be defeated is the most frightening one imaginable. Anyway, sleep tight.
Oh, wasn't that something? Don't forget to like, share and subscribe below, and also the people who made this lovely video, they're appearing right here. But if you're thinking to yourself, I want to see more content, Jules, then why not look above my head, as there probably is some. I don't know. I can't see it. Until next time.